back. Kind of a fast what's in the box without the box. I received a package of goodies in from Jim. He sent a bottle of wine to Christine, and he sent me this green bench IPA, 6.8%. Kiltum Wee Heavy from Bold City Brewery, Florida. And this is one I'm really looking forward to trying. Death Roll, Red Cypress Brewery. This is a milk stout. And it's got some cool cover art. Yet, I've learned, don't judge a beer by its cover. And then I got a couple of different beers in from the Crazy Scotsman. And the Crazy Scotsman always packs his beer in an ammo can. So, Scotsman, thank you. Every time you do that, you know that it just gets loaded with something. And I think I might actually use that one for 22, actually. I don't know if all the 22 will fit in that. The first one is Fear Movie Lions Double IPA. This one weighs in at 8.5%, and it's an unfiltered. And this is Double Cannon Double IPA. And this one is 9.5%. And I think today I am probably going to go take a look at this one. And if you want to know my thoughts on it, you need to... Yeah, that. I also received a package from my very good friend Jay at Elite Ammunition. If you follow me over at the Brew Channel, which is usually more politics and firearms than brews, you know that when it comes to gunsmithing, I cannot say enough about Jay's skills. My kick-ass FN57 was completely reworked by Jay. Jay's responsible for some artwork on a an 80% Glock build that I did, and he went over the top on my Desert Eagle. As a matter of fact, in case you haven't seen them, this was the Glock project. I sent it to him and just said, do whatever the hell you want. So, love it or like it, I think it's unusual, and I like it. Then, my nighttime home defense and carry gun, of course, it hasn't been getting carried as much lately because of something else, which I'll show you in a moment. But the amount of work that Jay did to this, his custom trigger, upgraded the sights to Trijicon night sights, the longer threaded barrel, he goes through the entire inside and polishes. And it, right now it has a little over, I think it's 2.25 pound trigger. And when you plus one this, you get 21 rounds. And I am carrying Jay's T6Bs. These go through just about anything. And Pete over at the Armory Channel made me two holsters, one with the light and the laser, and one without. And then I know it's a very dangerous thing to send somebody something kind of pricey, and you just say, I'm leaving this completely up to you. This is the job that Jay did to my Desert Eagle. He did a trigger job, just kind of cleaned it up a little bit. I did not want something really light on something with a heavier recoil. He did a set of custom grips on it. I'm calling this finish Liberal Tears and loving it. And he made a custom set of sights. I really like the blacked out rear blade. And this is just little things like the reworking of the trigger and getting it all cleaned up. So Jay sent me a mega zine. Thank you, Jay. And last and definitely not least, you people that follow me over on my personal disgrace book, Facebook page, you've already seen this, but my man and my friend David Brown, we rented a table and did we brought the woman's build, and we brought all the information for Justin's final mission down to the biggest gun show that we have in our area. And David was down manning the table, and he calls me, and he sends me a couple pictures of one of his of two of his guns, and he goes, "You got to get down here. I got a guy down here with a laser engraver." And I just happened to be carrying this. This is the Ruger that Ed gave me. So I had them laser engrave hashtag be like Ed on one side and Ed USAF on the other is a tribute to Ed. And again, if you, this guy, I'm sure you've all got people in your area that do, laser engraving. This guy was a true Second Amendment loving guy. Some of the stuff that he had, imagine Hillary Clinton in a jumpsuit, but where the lines are, which looks like bars, was left black, so it looked like Hillary Clinton behind bars. He had all sorts of really cool stuff. So, okay, I don't want this to be long. I just want to say thank you to Jim, the Hornet Fixer, for the beer care package. We're going to go take a look at one right now over at B&E Brewery Views. Crazy Scotsman, again, thank you. I'm really looking forward to trying this one here and using the ammo can. And Jay from Elite Ammunition, thank you. The mag is cool as hell. And again, if you are looking for anything for the 5.7 and you need any kind of gunsmithing, right now he still has two of mine. I'm waiting. The M1 carbine, yeah, I get that all sorted out, but I'm really looking forward to getting the Smith & Wesson 6.45 back with the competition barrel bushing and a few other love concerns taken care of on that. So, okay, guys, you guys, cheers, and I'll put links down below. If you're not subscribed to Hornet Fixer, your Hornet Fixer, the Crazy Scotsman, or Elite Ammunition, Jay's channel, I'll have the links all down below. Cheers. I'm gonna go drink a beer. Beer!
Boom, motherfucker!